Hi, and welcome back to Finally Revealed. In this episode, I want to go back and talk some more about feminine and masculine energy. This video is going to be directed primarily to men who are dealing with women in the workforce, which is a lot of people, if not everyone. And it doesn't need to be in an office setting. It can be any type of workforce, working around the home, working as a volunteer. I just want to highlight the fact that in our society, anything related to work has a foundation of masculine energy. And we refer to the patriarchy as the overall system that has been in place for many, many decades because it was set up by men and systems created by men. Not making any judgment as far as it being good or bad, that's just the way it is. So you can think to comments like, it's a man's world, or a woman in a man's world. And we throw those sayings around all the time, but do you really understand what that means to a woman or to a man who's mostly in his feminine energy? Both males and females and everybody else in whatever their identity is have masculine and feminine energy. And they're most noticeable as far as attracting or repelling. Now, how this relates to the workplace, just bear with me just for a minute. When two people are both in their feminine energy, they're on parallel tracks, they're simpatico. When they're both on their masculine energy, same thing. Think of your friends and how you are with your friends versus your significant other or somebody that you're interested in on a personal level. You can see the difference, hopefully. In the workforce, which is identified as the masculine domain or the man's world, and not just the system, but then when there's the people that are mostly men, and a woman comes into that system, it's a very general statement, to be successful so far, they have to adopt to that masculine energy template until they get to a certain level, and then sometimes even then. So masculine energy is that get things done, put it on the calendar, organize it, push forward, get the agenda done, finish that meeting, finish that phone call, get that report done, and have your different people that work for you, give them identified assignments, and then you on your reports up the food chain, who do you report to when, and let's just keep everything going. Think of the army. That's a perfect example of masculine energy in the patriarchy and work, all right? And part of the discussion on do we let women in there, do we let gay people in there, or different people in different identity into this male-dominated masculine energy scenario, that really shines a bright light on what this is. So when you are dealing with a woman who rises to the level, a successful level in business, she has had to adapt, whether or not her default setting is masculine, which some women do have the default setting as masculine, but regardless of what her default setting is, we both have both sides, but for them to get up to a certain level, they have had to get into their masculine energy, operate in that masculine system repeatedly, continuously, for a very long time. You may have professional women that you've dated or that you've been around that have been your friends. They're always in work mode. That's the masculine energy. And men have set up this system that suits them because they were setting the system up. If women in their feminine energy or men in their feminine energy had set up all of these systems, it would be a lot different. So the majority who set it up, set the system, and the other people coming in have had to adapt. So some of those things are changing and the men don't understand. And a lot of women have bought into it because that's business without realizing it's the masculine energy. So just so you understand, a feminine woman who's primarily in feminine energy, which is receptive, which is sitting back, it's not less powerful than the masculine, it's just different. And so they are going against their natural energy pattern in order to fit in, and not just fit in, but to push forward, to succeed and rise in that position. And so it's important for you to understand that's what's going on. If you say, she's pushy, and we get a lot of comments that say, oh, well, if I was a man, I would be a superstar. But if as a woman, I'm bitchy or I'm pushy or I'm naggy, it's because you have the feminine energy as label for the woman. And now that woman is coming across in her masculine energy because that's the system that she's in. And if she wants to get from A to B, this is how the game is set up. Until the rules are changed, that's the way that it is. So I have a system that I have created. I'm going to do it separately from this YouTube channel, but I'm going to have additional videos here on the YouTube channel for the women and the men who are around them to understand how to recognize when the shift occurs in the energy, how to make that shift occur, and for the people around to understand what she is going through, what is happening. And for the men who are a default setting of feminine energy, I want to hear from you too, because this is happening to you too. This is your adaptation to adjust also. And then we'll go into separate things, and I don't want to be derogatory, but you've heard feminazi or whatever, or the feminists, and feminists can have lots of different connotations. But there are different levels of the masculine energy, empowered and impaired, and the same thing with the feminine energy. We can only control ourselves. If we can recognize where we are on the spectrum of the energy, we can get some great insights into what is going on around us, and we can adjust. And I'll share a little bit about my story on this too, because I had, through my job, got way over onto the masculine. I was very effective there, but then, wait a minute, then you have to find your way back. And I want to help women do that, but I want you guys to understand what this is all about. And it may give you some insights into the women in your life, or if you're a masculine energy woman, into the men in your life, because on a personal level, we match up with the opposite, with the one that's the opposite most of the time. And so hopefully this was helpful. If you learned something, give me a thumbs up. Leave any comments or questions below. Subscribe to see the other videos and come back and see me next time. Thanks for watching.